Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a simplified version of my leg-efficient and expandable floor double stairs. In this tutorial I will show you two ways to build this, one which is a direct upgrade from the old version, and the second which is a bit more compact, but also a bit more expensive. So, let's show you those two things in action first. So, both work pretty much the same. At the beginning we have a flat area with some stairs in the floor, and after the activation of the whole thing here we have a double stairs going upwards, which can be used for example for some kind of entrance or a stadium or something similar. Both versions work pretty much the same and are activated by changes in the signal at the front here. So this is essentially how this thing here works. Now let's talk about the sizes of the whole thing. The old version, or this version here, which is an upgrade of the old version, is a total of 3 blocks wide, a total of 6 blocks high, plus 2 blocks for the stairs to extend into, and 1 block long for each module. And as you can see, it's a modular design, with the first module being a bit different and all other a lot simplified, which spares a lot of resources. So the second version is also 3 blocks long, 1 block wide for each module, but only 5 blocks high. So this is a bit more compact. The downside here is that it needs a control circuit which makes the whole thing here 1 block wider in comparison to the other version here. It's also a bit more expensive, but this you will see in a few seconds. So anyway, this is the sizes for the whole thing. Now let's go to the resources. You will need, of course, some building blocks. Then for this version here, with the extra control module, you will need 1 redstone dust, 1 repeater, 6 observers, 1 hopper, and a lever, for example, as an input. Instead, for this version here, you will need an additional 4 observers, 1 hopper and a lever. So as you can see, this version is a bit more cheaper than this one here. And then for each module you will need, of course, the 2 stairs, then 4 observers, 3 sticky pistons, and then some blocks, of course. But that's essentially all you're gonna need, so let's quickly show you how to build those two versions here. Okay, so for the first version, let's start with the general layout. So this is essentially the position of the stairs later on, and this is how far you have to go down below the floor, so 6 blocks below the floor essentially. And then let's start with the first module in the way built as the old version. So essentially we are making kind of a half circle of observers here, then another observer going up here, block on top, then a hopper on top, another observer up there, then a block here, another block here, and finally let's place in our 3 sticky pistons and the 2 stairs. And that's the first module, so this is the old version essentially. Let's quickly put our lever here in front. So all you need to do to trigger this here is give this observer here an output update, and the whole thing here will work. So then we can remove this one here. It was just to give you a general idea. And that's, as I said, the old version. And in the previous tutorial I would have copied this over and over essentially, but now all you're gonna need to do is take an output from this hopper here and from this observer here, run this a few modules, and then just observers on top, blocks on top, and then put in the sticky pistons. And then the stairs on top. And that's already the entire thing finished. So very simple and a lot cheaper than the old version. If you have already built the old version, as you can see, all you're gonna need to upgrade this is just remove the old parts down here and replace them by those hopper lines here, observer lines there. Okay. So for the second version, let's again start with the layout. We have again this as the position for the stairs later on, and then here laid out 5 blocks below the floor we need to go. Then, let's quickly remove those blocks for a moment. Let's start with this lowest block there. Let's first put an hopper up there, then an observer facing upwards, then right besides it an observer facing downwards, followed by a row of 3 or a column of 3 observers facing downwards, and another one in this direction, and finally a block right in the middle. Redstone on top of the middle one, and a repeater on top of this one here. Make sure this is on one tick. And that's already our input here, so you can put a lever, for example, right here. And that's the control circuit. So for the next part, all you're gonna need is, again, grab a row of observers, place them going from this observer there, then from this observer down here, this observer here, then the observers going upwards, blocks on top, then the sticky pistons in the middle, and finally the stairs on top. And as you can see, now everything works properly. And that's that. Okay, so that was how you can build this simplified, lag-efficient and expandable floor double stairs. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!